So with your kind permission, again, I would like to request the order of the presentations today would be first years, followed by second years, followed by third years. So the first opportunity we are giving to the first year students to go ahead with the presentation. Naveen, Srihari, Prasuna, Sophia and Likita, please go ahead.
A very pleasant good afternoon to sir and our seniors. Hello.
Good afternoon. Who is speaking?
Sir, this is Naveen Nadimpalli, sir.
Naveen Nadimpalli is speaking. Okay, great.
Okay, a very pleasant good afternoon to every senior and our sirs who present in this meeting. And from first of all, paper only, we can see that we are making a money bags with a good farming crops.
Wow.
So our team works with Naveen, Srihari, Prasuna, Sophia, Likita. I am very appreciative all the team members, sir.
Fantastic.
And presentation on farming as a business. Okay, sir. So shall we move, sir, slide?
Lovely, sure.
Okay, our name of the enterprise is Healthy Organics, Steps Towards Healthy Life. So our company making steps towards healthy life for everything in the planet.
Wow.
So move slide, sir. Okay, I said in front of that our promoters, namely Healthy Organics promoters, we five members work together, and our company forwarders. Sir, shall we move, sir?
Lovely. Promoters' names?
Naveen, Srihari, Prasuna, Sophia, Likita are the promoters, the main promoters to our company, and good forwarders and good always suggesters to our company, sir.
Lovely.
Okay, our company main objectives and main motto is fully agriculture oriented, our company is, and we don't want to waste any resources. We want to conserve every resource without any exaction and never uses any harmful chemicals. So our main tagging only that tells that we want a healthy life, so we don't want to use any harmful chemical. We want a good life and good healthy life. So we fully believe on nature, and we trust on nature, and we are moving our company with belief on nature only. Okay, then we have so many waste. Some members said which material is waste, that from that material we have to make a good product, and we have to make that recycle, and we have to make successful.
Sure.
Okay, sir, shall we move slide, sir?
Enter.
When we come to main theme, vision. So we saw first point to see a healthy globe without chemicals food in future. So if you check the past years, so many members crossing 100 years. It's not easy thing. But nowadays, getting 100 years is a record, is a difficult process, all members thinking like that. Because of the chemical food only, a person not live strong life and more life. So he is losing his life because of chemical food. So we want to see in future a good, healthy life, strong person.
Sure.
And good. And second point is to provide a genuine organic products. So our company main vision is we don't want to lose trust, because who the customers comes with trust. So we want to make them more trust, but we don't want to lose any type of trust on me. So we want to provide a good organic product, sir. And our mission is to protect every ecosystem in the planet. We don't focusing on human ecosystem. We are focusing every ecosystem, that aquatic ecosystem, plant ecosystem, human ecosystem, because every ecosystem is interlinked in this planet. So we want every ecosystem good. So we are focusing every ecosystem, sir.
Yes.
And to provide a good benefit to producer and consumer means we don't want to cheat any consumer. And we don't want to lose the farmer as any who produces something. We don't want to lose any single person also. So we want to benefit the producer, consumer, everyone. Our main motto, second logo, sir, second point, and to provide quality products at fair price. Some people think that quality products come at high cost only, but our vision and our mission is we want to give to every citizen, every middle class person also wants to get a fair, at fair price, good quality things. So, sir, we can move slide, sir.
Sure.
And we coming to products and services offered by our company. So here we want to listen carefully. So because organic compost, so many people think that no organic fertilizers compete with the fertilizer, chemical fertilizers. It's absolutely wrong answer. When I asked me, there are so many fertilizers which compete with the chemical fertilizers. Example, vermicompost, neem beets, so many are, when we study first year also, so there are many organic compost. We want to serve the every farmer good compost or products, one of the products. And we want to establish organic market. Means, here we don't want to give the products to other persons. We want to establish an organic market. Means we only provide a market which comes from direct producer to sales a consumer. What are products like vegetables and fruits, so many, milk, curd, like that, they comes from. And third point, organic dairy market, sir. Organic dairy market means here we want to say about two things. One is here dairy market from waste of buffaloes, cows, like that. Dairy farm means fishes, any dairy farm, we come some sewage product, means waste things. We have to make that useful. We have to make as a fertilizer, that organic fertilizer. We have to make to sell that one also very useful as, and from dairy we can sell that milk, fishes from fish dairy farm, like that we sell the products from dairy farm and we get the materials from dairy farm.
Okay.
So we will use two products, sir, and organic body products. What in we are seeing nowadays, from today morning, wake up morning, we are using so many things, paste, hair oil, soaps, etc., etc., etc. So we don't want to, because we want to satisfy every person, every consumer, every customer who trusted me. We want to give satisfaction. This company has all things. This company is providing everything. So we are making our ointments, medicines, everything we are making, body products also, and selling by our market only in our company. And our friend and our team member, my friend Likita, will forward this, our plans.
Thank you, fantastic. Thank you, Naveen. Wow, very energizing and inspiring. Thank you. Go ahead, Likita.
Thank you.
Thanks for giving this opportunity once again for me. I'll continue the presentation which Naveen left it. Now I am going to explain about the business plan of our company. Our business plan, firstly, we started with the capital investment in the first year. In the sense, we find to have a good supportable capital for our business. We try to find out the best place to set up our company or the business products. And in the second stage, we make to have a publicity and well awareness and trust on organic farming, because nowadays mostly organic farming are often firstly admitting by the farmers, they wanted to have a more organic farming rather than a artificial or for a chemical for forming, sir. And then we have is that in the third stage we learn, we make to have a learned lands from farmers and use the products that are that are made by us. So in another sense, I would like to say this: we use our products in the farmers. I mean, in the farms, to make the fields are produce the best quality products and food materials, with our organic fertilizers or compost, whatever we farm, and these organic products are farmed by gathering some e-waste from the surroundings or from the state countries in our places, which we convert them into a useful manure to make our products for the farming, and for better yields we used to have the crop rotation during this process of third stage. We used to have a crop rotation according to the seasons to make our product to make the field of farming easy and in a great way to get the great benefits and profits for our business. And and the marketing includes the distribution of company compost bin and membership for the people. Likewise, also conducting organic awareness programs, offering internship programs, which leads to many jobs, uses of online media for our company to make it the most publicity or viral in the all over the globe. And next, in conclusion, to the expected turnover, estimated profit, as it be like in the business way, we have to face a loss at the starting stages of the investments or business starting. Oftenly, there is a theory that once the transition period has passed, usually in 3 to 5 years, organic crop yields often rebounds with the 90% of conventional yields. So we have a thought to have this, and starting stages, maybe after getting into this fourth stage or fifth stage, profit merely increases towards the 37.4% margin lines of the investment. And coming to the customer base, as well as we know that the customer base, in a sense, smaller section of base being compressed to of repeat customers. For this, to attract the customers to our business products, we make to use the TMQ method. I mean, total quality management method, which makes them to attract to our products and to have a repeat customers base, core customers for our business, and it also optimizes the competitiveness. And the supplies will mostly preferable to direct consumers. Our supplies would be mostly preferable for the direct consumers rather than this wholesalers or retailers. We try our best to have our products directly reach to the consumers, in the sense farmers, with the low cost and preferable things, sir. That's it, sir, for this business plan. And I just want to make it and another thing is that, sir, organic vegetable plants can fetch at least 30% more than conventional plants, sir. It's a statement, sir. Thank you for this opportunity. Now further presentation will be concluded by my friend Prasuna. Thanks, sir.
Thank you so much, Nikita. Excellent. Superb. Prasanna?
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
This is Prasanna Akiana, and I'm here to let you know about the risks in setting up of the risks we face during sorry, sir.
No problem.
Here are the risks in setting up the business. organic farm business. And coming to the first one, it's all about the production risks. Production risks relate to the possibility that our yield or output levels will be lower than projected. Okay. Major sources of production risks arise from adverse weather conditions such as drought, freezes, or excessive rainfall at harvest or planting. Production risks may also result from damage due to insects, pests, and disease despite control measures. Yes. It also includes from the failure of equipment and machinery such as an irrigation pump, etc.
Okay.
And coming to the next one, it's all about the marketing risks. Marketing risks relate to the possibility that we'll lose the market for our products or that the price received will be less than expected. Marketing risks can also arise from loss of market access due to the wholesale buyer or processor. Or if a product fails to meet market stands or packaging requirements, it comes under the marketing risks.
Okay, sure.
Next one is about the financial risks. Financial risks relate to not having sufficient cash to meet the expected obligations, generating lower than expected profits, etc., and losing equity in the farm. In addition to the financial risk, may also be caused by increased input costs, higher interest rates, excessive borrowing, higher cash demand for family needs, lack of adequate cash or credit reserves, and everything comes under this financial risk. Legal risks in the sense, legal risks that include environmental risks too, because environment is not always supportive to the farmers. In part, legal risks relate to fulfilling business agreements and contracts. Okay. Failure to meet these agreements often carry a higher cost. Another, causing injury to another person or property due to negligence. This also comes under the legal risks. And legal risk is closely related to environmental liability and concerns about water quality, erosion, and pesticide use, sir. These, I'm done, sir. Thank you, sir, for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, Prasuna. Now, I want to talk about the gains and benefits in our organic farm business. Firstly, fertile land. As we use organic manure and vermicompost, we do not have soil degradation and soil erosion, and we will have fertile land which will last for many years. So we can say that it will have a like many base investment and a good investment. And the next factor is low capital requirement. As we do not use any fertilizers and weedicides, we will have some low investment. And the other factor which comes is, as we do not use fertilizers and we use manure and compost are the rich sources which make the soil water capacity high. So we can say that we will have low investment for water irrigation processes. And the next thing is availability of resources. Our resources are generally from the own farm, as we make compost from ourselves and we make manure from ourselves from the dairy farming which we are doing besides the farm. And the next thing is we will have low competition. As organic farming is a new trend, there is no awareness among people and they are of the fear of risk that they will do not receive profits. So we hope we have low competition. And the next thing is high demand of organic products. Today's generation, we are mostly focusing on health, so you can say that we'll have a high demand for these organic products. And the next is agri biodiversity. We include biodiversity in our farm, organic in this healthy organics. As we cooperate with dairy farming, vermicomposting, we'll have, and in dairy farming, we'll have buffaloes, which give us manure, so that we'll have a good diversity between plants and animals. I'm done, sir. I will request Srihari to conclude.
Good afternoon. This is Srihari Bora from Visakhapatnam. I'm going to conclude this presentation. We mainly learned about this presentation, sharing knowledge, become united and speak on the topic. We came to know our mistakes individually. We got best idea from our team. While selling these products, reasonable profits, the many people gets employed and we can create all-round possibility. And mostly we encourage the female thoughts and their ideas, and it will make helps to a good entrepreneur. So these are the things I have learned from our presentation group. Thanking you, sir.
Fantastic. That is an excellent and amazing presentation. I really appreciated the confidence of the team, the concept of the team, and the slides are amazing, beautifully designed. Oh my God. And the confidence and your commitment, a sankalpa mandamiku, as organic, the nature, environment, sustainability, healthy life, healthy planet. That's a beautiful idea which is badly needed today, you know, and especially even this pandemic and everything is because of that, you know, our meddling with the nature, and you know, nature is correcting itself. And thank you very much. Your thought process is very good, and slides are beautifully designed. Naveen, Srihari, Prasuna, Sophia and Likita, right? Congratulations, you did a great job, and there's so much appreciation.